Should we go down? You go ahead. Seriously, go ahead. Josh? Do you remember Josh Dinesburg? No. No, Eddie was like obsessed with him. Like, sick obsessed. Hey, Josh?
Annie here?
Yeah, she is. You should come over for dinner tonight.
Thanks. I got stuff I gotta do. Thanks.
No, you have to. She's gonna be so excited. Dinner's ready.
Okay, here we go.
It looks beautiful.
Big camera. Is it digital? Is it?
Mm-hmm.
So we're in your documentary?
Right now you are.
Is she gonna eat?
No. She can only eat one.
You gotta be hungry.
I said no.
She has since she was little. It's not really a good big deal.
Do you want to piece me up pasta?
I eat a little lot too.
Parmesan?
Yeah, please.
Yeah.
Okay. So, you see how the lines of your palm are shallow? It just means that you're a young soul.
Is that good?
Well, it's neither good or bad. It's just, it just means that you have to come back for more life forms to continue learning. Okay. Two kids.
That's true, too.
Who'd you have two kids with?
Molly from high school.
Yeah. Well done. She was a babe.
Yeah, she was. And we're not together anymore.
Uh-huh. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, it's been a rough summer.
That it has.
For all of us. Mm-hmm. I wanted to tell you guys how sorry I am about your mom. There's a bunch of us who tried to help, and, by the time they got some divers in, I think it was just too deep. How'd you hear about it?
Through the sheriff's department. Like, 5 days after the fact. Because they had a hard time finding us.
Sorry. Is here for a memorial?
No, she's clear she didn't want that kind of thing.
She's here to, you know, figure out the next step and take care of some affairs.
Though, like, coming back home is the part that makes you feel like it's so strange. It's like this lake has a power. I can't explain it. It's like a draw.
Yeah, no one's ever found the bottom. It's pretty strange.
Remember that story that Mom used to tell us? The one about the seven sisters?
Yeah.
Do you remember?
I do. So the first sister jumps in, and she never resurfaces. So then the second sister jumps in to try and save her, but she gets pulled down. And the third sister jumps in, tries to save that sister. Same thing happens. And one by one, they all jump in trying to save each other and drown.
The legend of the story is that you can go out at midnight and summon up the spirit of the seventh sister. There have been people who've seen her, but if you go swimming, there has been talk that it may be the last time you swim.
Oh, God, it's crazy.
Ooh.
What time is it? Okay, so what do we have to do to conjure the seventh sister?
First of all, you have to speak from your heart. In order for the seventh sister to rise and show herself, you have to say seven sister, seven times. No. Not now. I can't do it now.
I'm sorry.
Because if she's going to hear it, then we realize it's going to happen. But you're also supposed to... What?
I think we need candles. There's a whole bunch of them in the basement. Okay. 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 Okay.
with the permission of fire and the permission of matter, we now begin. Spirit of the Seventh Sister, I invoke thee. What kind of bird do you think it is?
I don't know.
It's got that orange belly. Pointy nose. Maybe it's a woodpecker.
I saw you doing it in the middle of the night. What is that?
I flew into the window.
Do birds even fly at night? What is he doing in the kitchen? How did you get him in here? It's a wild animal. They have diseases, guys. Isa, don't touch it. Isa, don't touch
it. Okay. I want to give it the proper burial.
Honey, let's just take him inside, okay? You're not keeping him inside right now. It's the middle of the night, okay?
And he hates funerals.
Thank you.
being. Our souls have sight of that immortal scene which brought us hither. That was William Wordsworth. Hello, I am Dr. Amelia Brooks, and I am the founder and president of the Blue Water Conservation Society. If you love our beautiful Blue Lake as much as I do, please vote yes on Measure F. Join me in standing up to greed and diving into blue.
May I please speak to Dr. Amelia Brooks? Oh, well, do you know when she might be back? Oh, no, I didn't. Oh. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm very sorry for your loss. No, thank you. Bye.
These are the comparables that are in your neighborhood that the appraiser was working off of. You might want to take a peek at those.
Okay.
And then, will we do a...
Who's this?
Oh, this is our sister, June.
Oh! Are you a photographer?
Mm-hmm. She's our family archivist. Will we have to do photographs for our own comp card, or is that something that your agency does?
Oh, definitely. I have a phenomenal photographer that will come out and take some pictures.
I have a question, though. How is this, like, a comparable if it's not on the water? And...
Well, because this is actually, you know, it's a newer home, but because it's not on the water, it's not going to have the same price. And due to the fact that this is an older home and it has a lot of issues,
so they kind of equal each other out. Yeah.
Okay, are you recording that right now?
It's not going to be.
She's just doing a documentary.
Yeah. Is it a documentary?
Okay.
Now, my other question is, do we have to fix the roofing and the electrical problems that the appraisers found, or can we just do a... property taxes and break the electrical code.
Well, what if there was a way to turn it into some sort of rental unit?
But then who's going to run the rental property? That's a lot of responsibility, and I know that I cannot take that on.
You wouldn't want to take that on?
No.
And I guess what I'm hearing is that you've already decided, and this is only one third yours.
I don't think I should be here. I think that you need to have this conversation.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to make it uncomfortable.
It's okay.
For you.
We'll discuss. I think you need to get on the same page because you don't want anyone walking in this door and you're not ready to sell.
Right. I'll walk you out.
All right. Sounds good.
If my dad were to give me a loan, then I could fix the roof and the other things. And then
what?
Well, that's the thing. I was talking to June before, and it was like we could, rent it out for different things. You know, like, there's, like, so many yoga schools that rent out places to do retreats and, like, art programs and just... I mean, what do you think, June?
What do you want to do, Jenny?
I don't really feel like it's my decision. I mean, it's Mom's house.
Competition. We've now moved on to the swimsuit portion of the evening. Now, you may be confusing me because this is a swimsuit, but it's not. However, it doesn't really matter because guess who's going to be nice and warm and dry and cozy on the way home? Unlike these two right here. I am.
Wait, I felt something.
What?
Come on.
Seriously, I felt something touch my foot.
Seriously, I felt something touch my foot. It was so scary. It was so scary. Ah! See? Lisa?
Funny, you guys.
Huh?
It wasn't very funny.
Oh, come on. You coming in?
No.
Come on.
You okay, Annie?
I'm fine. I can't do the camera right now, June. Sorry.
Okay, now I'm ready. So, tell me from the beginning.
There were seven sisters, and they were walking in a field with their mother, and Orion saw them walking through the field, and he fell madly in love with them, and he pursued them. He chased them everywhere for years and years, and finally, after 7 years, Zeus answered their prayers, and he turned them into birds so they could fly away, and they flew up into the sky. And then they became stars. They became the Pleiades.
Okay, but tell me the weird part.
Okay, the weird part is that there are seven sisters, but there are actually only six stars that are visible to the naked eye. And in spite of that, in almost every culture, the constellation is called the Seven Sisters. So there's this seventh star that everybody seems to know is there, and it is there, but completely invisible. And I just think that's really interesting.
Jesus Christ, you really scared me.
Why? What did I do?
Well, I heard a noise and woke up, but you weren't there.
What are you even doing out here?
I wanted to go swimming.
In the middle of the night?
Please don't do this to me again.
We found another bird.
Do you think it's a little strange that this is the second night in a row that it's happened? Maybe it's the change in weather. They just got confused. Yeah, but birds fly south. They don't just fall out of the sky.
You don't think that Josh would be doing this to you?
No.
No.
I'm sorry I scared you guys.
Josh, you didn't leave the birds, did you?
No.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
I thought you might be trying to scare us because of the whole Seven Sisters thing.
No.
It's just totally disrespectful. I just put them in the trash.
A certain time of day, and my dad calls the changeover. Mm-hmm. So the sun is about to set. Everything goes silent. All the waves of the lake just kind of stop. It only happens on this lake.
What is that? Definitely not a fish. No, that is a redfish. Yeah, I got it.
This is your first catch? And
yeah. Coaster.
The roller coaster's been closed since Labor Day.
Mm-hmm.
chose not to fish. You have to throw your line in to catch something.
You guys had a fishing trip planned, so I was just gonna do like a sister's breakfast because we haven't really had a chance to talk. But if you'd like to stay, I can set up
a place
for you.
No, I got stuff to do.
You
fine.
Sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See you later.
Gotcha.
I was actually thinking that maybe we could do like a full sister's day today. Take a break from
like a half sister's day.
What?
Like a half sister's day. It was just a joke because you said like a full sister's day.
Go on. I don't know. I was thinking I could maybe take you guys shopping and we could get some manicures and pedicures. We could go out for lunch. I mean, that's a big part of this trip for me, is spending time with you guys. So, I just thought that it would be fun. I mean, we don't have to. We can stay here. Or you can
you know, hang out with Josh or whatever.
No, it's not like I want to hang out with Josh over you guys. I just think it's funny that all of a sudden you're, like, all, like, about family and...
All of a sudden, like, all about family?
Yeah, all of a sudden. I mean, this is, like, the first time you've been home in like, over 10 years. You said it yourself. So it's just funny that...
That doesn't mean that I don't care about you. And that I haven't made a lot of efforts. I've invited you to Chicago so many times.
No, I know. It's...
And you've each come once. One time.
It's more like... I don't think you're, like, aware of how hard... I don't think you're aware of how hard it was for Mom to not have, like, reconciled with you.
Well, that is Mom's cross to bear.
Well, but it's yours, too. She wanted so badly to just have everything be okay with you. To the point where, like, go look in that bedroom. She brought the crib up and, like, put toys in it. She was so excited.
That has nothing to do with me.
Yeah, it does. It does. It was, like, a chance to reconnect with you. For you to be a mother and, like, know what it's like.
When I called her to tell her that I was pregnant, she barely acknowledged that. She immediately started talking about something to do with the lake. And, like, it was like, oh, that's nice, honey. She didn't care.
No, she did care. I mean, she set the crib up herself, and she brought out all of our toys, and, you know.
Well, I'm sorry that my miscarriage was so selfish, so inconvenient for her. God, well, I don't know what I was thinking.
Annie, that's not what I'm talking about.
She made it about her, just like she made everything about her.
Over the river forgetting, and that sort of wipes its memory clean of the life that it just lived, so you can go into the next one. And it just keeps happening, you know, at the end of life, just over and over again, different cycles of reincarnation. There's something very comforting about knowing you've already learned things and just forgotten them, like you just don't know how to see them.
I think if we could remember our past lives, when we were first babies, we might not want to live.
I haven't been to Mom's lab since I was little.
Me neither.
We should go.
These are Amelia's daughters. They're here to look at some of their mother's things.
Hey,
welcome.
Mine is.
And this was her desk. I'll be in the other room if you need anything.
When she was going deep water diving, that she was going for a spacewalk.
Did she really used to say that?
Yeah. Lake. August 18th, 170 feet. Fear, sadness. August 25th, 190 feet. Sadness, nostalgia. August 31st, 200 feet. She wrote, fear subsides. peep samples resemble amniotic fluid?
It's in the fridge.
Well, that's where we keep our samples.
I wonder if they still have some of our samples in there. I don't think she was excited. I think she was just trying to prove a point. What point was she trying to prove? Same point she was trying to prove every time she had a baby. This was just another baby. Dun Danny, Dun Danny, never happened. you learn that song? I just keep dreaming about it. You dreamt that? What language is it?
I don't know. I just woke up knowing those words. Just keep thinking.
Josh and I were talking today about the plans for the house, and he's really been helping me, like, solidify them. And I spoke to my dad. I think he's really on board. He just mentioned that I need a business proposal just to make it really official and, like, just like the structure.
Right.
I thought you might be really good at that.
I am really good at that.
I have a feeling.
Yes, I can absolutely help you with that.
Thank you.
If you kind of draft out all of your ideas, all of the thoughts that you've been having for this commune thing, then I will help put it into some structure and we can do a formal business plan.
I wouldn't say commune around here. I wouldn't use that word. So I think that you might get into a little bit of hot water, but it's more like a school or
like a place for people to practice what they do. Like, I think that's missing from so many people's life. It's just like space, you know? Just like a space. Shut up. I'm serious, though. No, I'm super serious. But it's
so
true. No, but it's true. I don't know, but this might be amazing for you, is that we'd turn our bedroom into, like, a video editing facility.
Yeah, that would be great.
And you can come during the summer, and it's yours.
Yeah.
You know? And, but I also thought, like, make the sunroom like a painter's studio.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you have the light, you have the view. Why is that funny? It's a great idea.
I'm really kind
of... Like, we have a little bit of land. We could even grow things. It's just like, it's just...
We could be
she's
dying. I could be completely self-sufficient.
Wait, are you, like, into this or no? I can't tell.
I love that she's so into it.
See? I knew you would win.
I love it. That's great. Let's do it. Let's do it. Why not?
You should name it after your mom.
That's a really beautiful. The Amelia Brooks Art Institute.
Cheers.
I think too. Looks good.
Pizza. Do you remember? Come on, every day.
Justice for our lake. Justice for our lake. Justice for our lake. Justice for our lake. No, no, we won't go. No, no, we won't go. No, no, please, 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 please.
Thank you. You look just like the girls ready for bed. I asked you over half an hour ago to get them into their pajamas and to brush their teeth, and nothing has happened. Why aren't they ready for bed? You never listen to me.
Do you have no respect for your mother? You're such a little daddy's girl. That's the only person that you'll listen to. I asked you to help with your sisters. Must I do it all on my own? I have to do everything all on my own. The only person who loves me in this whole house is the dog. Do you want me to just sleep with the dog? Is that what I should do? Is that too much to ask? I have to get up early in the morning. Let me go again. I'm gonna go again and I'm just gonna do the song. Okay, I'm just gonna do the song. Okay? Forget to breathe, Junebug.
It's beautiful, June.
Yeah, it is very beautiful, but I didn't take it. That's what I wanted to ask you guys about.
You mean we didn't take it?
You think we took it?
Well, I didn't take it. So somebody else did. I woke up this morning and this footage was on my camera and I didn't take it.
Are you sure you didn't take it a couple days ago and you just didn't check it?
Yes, I'm sure. You guys were sleeping on the couch, and I left my camera down here. I really actually don't care if you did. I just want to know.
Yeah, but first of all, I wouldn't touch your camera.
And yeah, I wouldn't touch your camera either.
Just, it's not funny anymore. I'm getting really
freaked out. But I'm not trying to play a joke on you. I just didn't touch your camera.
All right, this is getting really weird. What?
I found another bird this morning.
I told you already about the birds. It's just the time of the year. It's not.
I would be able to avoid that if it was just one, but every single day.
I know, but it's at the time of year they fly.
Do you promise me?
I can't see, so.
June, I swear I didn't touch your camera. I wouldn't do anything like that.
I really, really don't care if you did, but it's just.
But I didn't. You just have to believe that I didn't. I don't like getting blamed for it. I think we should call the police.
What are you going to tell the police?
We need to report that somebody broke into the house and stole her camera.
Okay, somebody broke into the house, they stole the camera, they went out to the dock, and then they filmed
something really weird is going on.
And then they just decided to leave the camera.
Yeah, that's a crime, isn't it? I mean, do you think Mom could be doing this?
Jesus, come on.
Why are you laughing at me? It's not funny.
Okay, June, your mom came back from the dead. She does have to use the camera. She went down a lake. She did a time lapse just for fun, and then she put it back in for you just to have fun. I mean, you guys gotta. Really?
Let's just leave it.
All right.
I just have this really bad feeling that night that we went out and we summoned the seventh sister, that we like opened some kind of door that we should
not open.
That's all it is, okay? And you know what? Let's go see Maggie Helms. She's lived here forever. She knows all about the folklore.
You can ask her about the Seven Sisters, okay? That'll make you feel better.
In the olden days, the period costumes were so heavy and so layered, This particular family was very conservative, and they didn't want their seven girls to disrobe and swim. And this one night, it was so sweltering hot that they snuck out at midnight, took off their clothes, and went for a swim. The first sister went in and didn't emerge, and the second one followed and didn't emerge. And the third and fourth, all seven went in.
Do you think that, if you summon the seventh sister, then she'll pull you under next time you swim?
You know, I don't know about that. I know that I had a very odd experience many years ago. I went into the water off the dock, and I dove down, and suddenly I saw this tiny light, very bright light. It was simply beautiful, and I felt this pull toward it, till all of a sudden, it wasn't a comfortable pull. I felt that I had no power to stop from going down, so I fought to turn myself around. It was as if I was fighting a current, and with all my strength, I rose to the top of the water, and I remember gasping for breath, and as I approached the ladder, this overwhelming sense came to me that I should go back or look back, but it was a very great sense of loss that I have even to this day, that I left something down there. So, you girls, you dear girls, you take good care, please. Just use wisdom.
If you want, you can stay with me. It'll make it easier. Make you feel better.
Yeah, I don't know.
You guys actually... You still think about selling the house?
Mm-hmm.
I thought you said you wanted to stay.
Hmm.
Can you just back off? You know, that's just my talk.
Dream it?
No, it stopped. And I'm kind of relieved because there's always something that felt like it was calling me to somewhere, something dangerous. Jim, don't go swimming in the lake.
No.
Yeah.
Hi. Can I sleep with you guys tonight? I don't want to be alone.
Yeah, of course.
You okay?
Yeah. I felt like such a little kid. Every little noise that I heard was making me feel so freaked out. And I started holding my breath in bed, and I swear it. Heard a baby crying. This is my mind playing tricks on me.
I think something is telling us to grow.
Impossible. I didn't take this. Something really, really weird is going on.
Okay, I need you to put down the camera. The little girl.
Why? Let's just talk about this, okay?
We should talk.
We can talk about it with the camera.
Put it down, June.
You guys, I didn't take that.
She's not asking, June. Put the camera down.
I'm not gonna put the camera down.
Take a deep breath, June. Take a deep breath. It's okay. We're so proud of you for
how far you've come and how well you've been doing, and we just don't want to see you revert back. And I think that being home is just, it's too hard. It's too hard for you. It's too hard for all of us.
But I'm doing really well.
I went into your closet, and I noticed that you have the shawl. And I went to pick it up, and inside of it I found a dead bird.
We know that you've been sneaking out at night, and you've been leaving the birds, and the time lapses. I think that we should all go out onto the dock and say our goodbyes to Mom, and then we should go.
But the camera's not invited.
We're not going to do this again. We've been down this road before. And we're not going to do it again.
See that you're starting to spiral out of control.
I'm not spiraling out of control.
And the doctors have always told us that when we are with you, we enable you.
Oh my God, I'm not out of control. The doctors are idiots. They don't know anything. I'm sorry if you're too scared to deal with it. I'm sorry if you're cowards, but I'm your sister.
You listen to my words right now. I'm not doing this with you again. We're leaving in 3 hours, and you can get in that car and go home with us.
How can you talk to me like that?
Or you stay. It's your decision. It's your decision.
What is wrong with you? What the hell is wrong with you guys? I hate you so much! Oh, I hate you guys!
inland far we be, our souls have sight of that immortal sea which brought us hither. Our birth is but a sleep and a forgetting. The soul that rises with us, our life's star, hath had elsewhere its setting, and cometh from afar. Not in entire forgetfulness, and not in utter nakedness, but in trailing clouds we come.
Thank you.